I know who she is, he replied. How is she? Fine, I think, she answered. She has a few grazes and some minor injuries. We took her to the emergency room. Arlander chased her with a fire iron, and she sustained the injuries when she slipped. She got to her car and out onto the main road, but ended up skidding on the ice and driving into a ditch. It was the vehicle recovery company who alerted us, actually. When we found out what had happened, we decided to bring Arlander in. Good, Blix commented. And when we went to arrest him, we discovered some drugs at the cabin, she continued. So, he'll have to answer for both the drugs and the incident. Is there anything you want us to do, seeing as you asked to be notified? I'll drive down to you, Blix replied, thinking quickly about the meetings he had that day. The first was with Ruth Christina's parents at the hospital. How long can you hold him for? As long as you need to get here. Chapter 30. The door to Anita Grönvold's office was closed. Emma shuffled a little in the hard visitor's chair. Both her hip and arm were sore after her encounter with the ditch in Undrumsorsen the previous night. I'm really sorry about what happened to your car, she said. I filled out the damage report. The workshop said it should be ready in a week. Anita dismissed it with a wave. He came after me, Emma continued. I thought he was going to follow me in his car as well. I panicked. The road was just sheet ice. Everything went wrong. What were you doing there in the first place? Anita inquired. I went on an impulse, Emma began. I had a feeling that Sophus Arlander had something to do with the Patricia case. What made you think that? Emma raised her hand to touch the plaster above her eye, covering the place where the door had hit her. She told Anita about how she had followed Blix and Kovic and had then gone to Undrumsorsen to find out who Sophus Arlander was and what he knew.